Hi, I'm Robin Worley. Welcome to Lenscraft. Last week I explained how to change the colour of an object in Affinity Photo using the colour replacement brush. The colour replacement brush is a great tool, but it's not the easiest way to change the colour of an object in Affinity. That award probably goes to the hue adjustment layer. If you haven't used this before, I think this video will surprise you with what's possible. Start by opening the image you want to adjust. I'll be using the shot of an old door to change the colour of the door and later change the colour of the surround as well. To do this, I'll add an HSL adjustment layer in the Adjustment Studio panel. Unlike with the colour replacement brush, because this is an adjustment layer, it means that it's non-destructive. If I get into a mess, I can reset the adjustment using the reset button, or if I get into a complete mess, I can delete the entire layer and just add a new one. In the HSL dialog, you can see there's a colour wheel, and below this there's several colour samples you can use. The sample on the far left has lots of colours in it. When you select this sample, any adjustment you apply affects the entire image. To make an adjustment to the image, I'll use the hue, saturation and luminosity sliders. The luminosity slider controls how dark or light a colour is. Because I've selected the all colour option, the adjustment affects the entire image. Notice also what's happening to the outside of the colour wheel. The outside is turning white or black depending on which way I move the slider. That's because the inside of the wheel is showing the colours of the original image, whilst the outside shows the effect of the adjustment I'm applying. The next slider is the saturation slider, which controls the colour intensity, and again, it's currently affecting all the colours in the image. By the way, if you want to reset a slider after making an adjustment, just double-click the slider. Next, we have the hue slider, which I can use to change the colours in the image. As I move the slider left and right, all the colours in the image are changing, and it can be difficult to understand what's happening. But there is an easy way to do this. Watch what's happening again to the colour wheel. Notice that the outside colours are rotating around the inside wheel, and that's showing you what's happening to the image. Remember this because it can be very helpful in controlling the hue slider. Now let me show you how easy it is to change the colour of the door. Because the door's blue, I'll pick the blue colour sample. Notice there's four dots now appear in the colour wheel. These are showing the range of colours I selected when I click the blue sample. Any adjustments I make affect all the colours in the colour wheel that fall between the two inner dots. The two outer dots mark the full extent of the colours affected by the adjustment. I won't affect any of the colours that fall outside of these two outer dots. The areas between the outer and inner dots are gradually affected by my adjustment and range between 0% and 100%. This is what helps blend the colour adjustment into the image. If I move the hue slider to the left, now you can see the colours on the outside of the wheel are shifting left, which turns the door pink. Notice that the adjustment hasn't affected the cyan colours in the door though. I could correct this by moving the hue slider further to the left, but that changes the door's colour further. Instead, I can click and move the four dots on the colour wheel. Moving the inner dots, I can widen the range of colours affected, changing more colours in the door. When I do this, I should also move the outer dot to maintain a gap between the two that helps blend the adjustments into the image. Let's say now that I want to change the colours of the terracotta tiles around the door. I could do this by adding a separate hue saturation layer, but I'll demonstrate it using the same layer. The colours of the tiles sit somewhere between red and yellow on the colour wheel. I'll pick red, but rather than immediately moving the hue slider, I'll use the picker tool. I can use this to sample the colour of one of the tiles that I want to adjust. As I do this, notice what happens to the red colour sample. It changes to show the colours that I've selected with the picker. Now I can turn the tiles blue by moving the hue slider to the right. At the moment, this is affecting the entire image, and if I don't want that, I can add a mask to the hue layer. Then I can use a black paintbrush to paint out the effect in some of the areas. And don't forget, if you find an area that's difficult to adjust with the hue layer, you could switch to using the colour replacement brush for that. If you didn't see my video for the Affinity Photo colour replacement brush, I'll include the link in the YouTube video description. I hope you found this video helpful. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft. I'll see you next week for another video. Thank you.